rebar, you have the outer crust, and you have the inside is concrete, and it's pretty amazing. And again, the concrete's poured after it's up. They pour it through funnels and cover much of the territory of the bollard.
Mr. President, also, this is a great view to look at the anti-climb. I defer to the commissioner to explain what that panel does.
Hey, you know what? I'd actually turn this over right now to our chief controller right now, Agent Harrison. He's really going to be able to give you, from an agent's perspective, exactly the magnitude of what this wall, the operation capacity, gives the Border Patrol agents.
Thank you, Commissioner and Mr. President. So you know, sir, this is the wall that the agents asked for. And they wanted me to tell you personally that they appreciate this, and not only this here, but the extension that is bringing the secondary out further out. They really appreciate it. It makes them safer, it makes the community safer, and it allows us to make that apprehension here in the border zone, as opposed to getting the vehicles and getting the pursuits on the highway. We want to make that apprehension here.
Well, you know, just in terms of the quality, I came with the Border Patrol. We worked with them very closely. I said, fellas, how about doing a less expensive version? They said, well, this is the version that works, including the poured concrete in the steel with the rebar and everything else. That's the Rolls-Royce version. And I said, well, fellas, how about doing one wall instead of two? In a lot of areas, we have two, where you have tremendous amounts of people on the other side trying to break through. We know exactly where those areas are. Tijuana being over here, as I said. And they said, well, sir, two works much better in these areas, a lot more expensive. So we have the one side on the border, 18, and then we have over here 30 feet. And I think one of the things you were asking, Mark, and wanted somebody to explain is the protector on top, how that stops. It's a anti-climb device, if you look at the steel on top. It's also structural, but actually it was there, more importantly, for anti-climb. Do you want to explain that?
So the panel's up there. So it's one thing to figure out how to navigate the vertical post, but the transition at the top makes the climb orders of magnitude more difficult. It requires different equipment, different tools, different skills, and so it's the change as we get to the top that adds to the protection of that fence.
And again, anything that we can do to give the Border Patrol agent even a few more seconds, a few more minutes to respond, that's a game changer. Sir, if you don't mind, I think this is important to talk about. The chief patrol, as you just mentioned, is that there's a false narrative out there that this wall is the president's vanity wall. I'm here to tell you right now that's false. This president, this administration, what they did is exactly what the president just explained. He reached out to the experts, to the Border Patrol agents that are on the front lines every single day, risking their lives, protecting this country, enforcing the laws that Congress enacted. He reached out to those agents, to those line agents, and asked, what do you need to do your job more effectively to secure and safeguard this country? And those Border Patrol agents said, we need this. So this president, thank you. You listened to the agents, and you gave them exactly what they asked for.
This is your maximum that you can do. And one thing we haven't mentioned is technology. They're wired so that we will know if somebody's trying to break through. And you may want to discuss that a little bit, John.
Sure, there could be some merit in not discussing that.
Okay. I like that. That was a great answer. I'll just tell you they're wired, okay? They're wired. They're technologically very advanced. All set up for cameras any place we want. We have all of the everything we need. But it's all set up for cameras, for anything. You've been hearing drone technology. They're all wired out for drone technology. Anything you want, we have. And frankly, this is the right time to do it, because to do it later after it's built is very expensive. This way, it's mostly just adding wire. So we're all set up to adapt. And that's the story. We have certain areas like this where you have double walls. If you look behind, you can see how that goes up the hill. And that goes many miles in that direction. And we're starting now many miles in this direction. We also have it all fits together like a puzzle. How many sites would you say over the next period of time will have been started?
There are probably about 35 sites at any one given point, all working. And some of the contractors, actually, if they build in 5 miles, they might be having one on one end, one on the other, and one in the middle. So they get the maximum amount of people building at the same time.